Let's create a very large area that's like a mountain range with rivers flowing through them. So to create that, I'll create a mountain range node. And it already comes with like a couple of peaks and a whole mountain system in between. But I'm going to increase the height like so. Maybe increase the bulk as well. Like go with really high bulk. Like this. And then let's see if I reduce the scale. There you go. That's cool. I think that's a very good starting point. What I want to do is I don't want to have too much detail. I think this is way too detailed, but I think I can get that out in erosion. So after adding this erosion node, one of the first things I do is increase the duration like quite high, reduce the downcutting just a little bit. And then down here in shape, I will reduce the detail that we get. So you can see some of the tinier details from the slopes are being reshaped into this larger, more cohesive, soft, regular shaping. So this is actually much closer to what you might see if you look at a mountain range on Google Earth, for example. So I want to play with this a little bit more. So if you reduce the sharpness, you can get these nice bulbous mountains without those sharper peaks. And then, of course, inversely, if you sharpen them, then you get these fantastic sharp peaks. So for our purposes, I'm just going to leave it right here on default, 0.6. That looks pretty good to me. What I will add are some coarse sediments. In fact, I'll go all the way with 1.0. And then play with the angle a little bit. I want to have them be lower so that the sediments are flowing down here and filling in the spaces down here as opposed to being up here on the slope. So that's where they're higher up on the slopes. So bringing them back down here, maybe adding a little bed load to just increase that. In fact, with the bed load, I can take the risk of having a slightly higher angle so we can have the best of both worlds, hopefully. Now I'm going to run a thermal pass on this. So that's adding a thermal 2 node. So it's creating, this thermal compaction. And then I'll add one more erosion node. This time with a very high erosion scale, lots of downcutting, of duration, and then again, coarse sediments and bed load. Play with the angle until I find something that I like so. And so I think I have my mountain range. Last thing I want to do is I want to add rivers. So this will now create this river network. Next thing is texturing. So let's take this, create a texture base. That's looking nice. What I want to do is I actually create two texture bases. This one will have higher emphasis on flow. Okay, maybe not that much, but yeah, higher emphasis on flow and soil, less on slope. Whereas the first one will have very high relevance or reliance on slope, very little on flow, and maybe just a little bit on soil. So with the first one, I'm going to create a sat map. And let's find something very earthy. This is fine. It's very noisy, but we're going to use color erosion, which will take care of all of this. So I'm not too worried about it. So let's leave it like this. And then I'll add to the second one, I'll add a sat map. And this one, I want it to be more green. So we have some options right here. And this is actually the inverse of what we want. So I'll reverse it. So there, so the areas with access to river water, they can be, brighter green or something like that. And then with this one, or rather, let's create a mix of both of these, just so we can have a bit of fun. I'll switch this to difference mode so we get this rather really highly textural map. I'll create one more set map. this one, let's get, like, so we have this. So I want to have something closer to that, but just a little bit different. Let me see what I can do with this one. Again, reversing it to see if it works. There, this is actually giving us a few nice options up here for trees or vegetation areas. I just switched it to this one, which I think looks better. I think that has, yeah, more variety in color. So anyways, with these three, I'm just going to select these three, right-click, and combine them into a mixer node. So this will help me create our kind of base template. So let's see. Let's look at this. That's our middle map. It's this one. And so I'm going to increase the warp on this so it's uneven with a smaller warp size. We're going to have more fall off, so it just blends more gently into this. You can bring it further down if you want to. And then we go up here, and this is the one where I actually wanted to have this green. So I think I can just easily drag this down here. So that's at the bottom, and now this one's here more at the top. So there we have our greener areas up here, and then down here we have this coming through. And I want to have some of this brown area left, just so we can give it like a, you know, a more varied look. Now, all of this right now does not look too realistic, and that's just fine, because next we create a color erosion node, which will then take our entire structure and let me make sure I connect this to our proper height output so it can run a simulation properly. And then with increased sediment density and blend, we get these beautiful flowing colors. You can see the rivers are being created right here along the existing river paths. And so that helps us create a more cohesive look for our terrain. So we go from having this to this. And then you can experiment with what you want. Like, for example, I'll reduce the blend so we get a little bit more of the original color, because I do want some of that graininess. You can increase the sediment density or reduce it. That'll also affect how much of the original values are being processed by the erosion. You can increase the transport distance or reduce it to see how far you want these flows to go. Like, I just want it to be maximum right now. And then lastly, you have the flow. So if you want, you can have it be like a bit higher, but that's just creating floodplains right now. And that's not looking as cool as we want it to be. So going back to this, you can see we have some of the dry areas down here and these greener, more fertile areas. Now, let's say we decide that now with what we have created, we want to go back and change things. So this one, which is at the top, we want it to be a bit different. So if I just change it a little bit here, so that it's like so, and then go back, you can see we now have these drier mountains with these rivers that have fertile areas nearby. So this is a great way to actually, change things after the fact. That's another beauty of procedural graph-based creation. And as just an added benefit, you can always lock preview here. You can right-click and lock preview, then go back to the mixer, and you can change things and have the color erosion affected in real time, and then you can see how that blends together. So, like right here, that's one way to see it. If I want to go back here and change this sat map completely, like if I go here like this, you can see it instantly affect the final output. So that way you can make a great informed decision. So there you have it. You have a large mountain system with rivers. If you want, you can also pull the river mask from here and then add some blue or green rivers to it, and then do a lot more.